Good morning, class.
Good morning, sir.
You know very well that yesterday I have discussed about many topics of international business, like what is the function of WTO and how IMF is performing in the betterment of the development of the different economies. Those are basically described are in low developing countries. This book is now renovated by the name of LDC, Lower Development Country. There is a development consistency is low or poor. These countries can learn well without the help of the IMF or World Bank. In the last 2017 year assessment of World Bank, if you will find that there is a country, Ethiopia. There is a country, Ethiopia, who has borrowed about $700 billion by the World Bank. It is not a tiny amount, it is a very big amount for an economy. And without the help of the WTO or the World Bank, it is not possible for countries like Ethiopia, like Vietnam, like Syria is also a part of that. Once there was a time where Syria was in very good mode. Syria is a developed country, we all know, but there is a right now is a problem of hyperinflation due to the some political reasons and also policy formulation. The policy that is implemented by the Syria is not heading towards the inflation. So now there are several reasons, now there are several basic reasons or problems of a country. Because of that, we are heading towards the global market. If Ethiopia is finding such kind of assets or getting the such kind of assistance by the World Bank or IMF, then Ethiopia is doing what about this money? Basically, they want to increase their exports, they want to increase their productivity. They are looking about the growth of their economy. That's why they are borrowing in tremendous amount. This is a big amount by the helping by the World Bank. So now we are talking about the modes of entry in the international market. How our economy can come into or go through the international market. Now there are many ways. Topic is modes of entry in global market. One thing more you should know about that, see, we have discussed already about that RTA, Regional Trade Agreement, PTA, Preferential Trade Agreement. There is also, before the coming of the WTO, GATT was working. These things, just because of development and growth of foreign trade by an economy, or we are looking global just because of being more earning and earning nature of the world. If you will find the best economies of the world like USA, China, Japan, these countries right now. Yesterday I have also discussed about the RCEP. India yesterday, in for yesterday, India denied to be the participant of RCEP. It is also a regional trade agreement. There are 15 members in the country in this type of organization. India denied just because of its interest. India knows very well. If India has signed on this document, China will take over its own market. The dairy products of the New Zealand and the Australia will be highly imported in our country, and it will definitely decline our own domestic market of dairy products. So Because of that, we are also very concerned about something, but we must know how we can grow in the global market. We must know how we can grow in the global market. There are several ways. Some of them are following. I am reading it through there is a graphical representation of this thing. It is classified in three ways. First is exporting. It is also divided into two parts. One is direct exporting, another is indirect exporting. Now next is contractual. It is also have some different subparts. One part is licensing. Another is advertising. And third one is turnkey project. Third one is investment. We know it is the last step. Joint venture. Very well. Another is good. Wholly owned subsidiary. These are the most known ways of getting into the international market. One thing was, it is very important why countries moving towards the global market. We have, as you know, I have told you earlier, India is exporting about how many products in global market? Around 7500 products we are exporting. I'm talking about our own country, India. We are exporting around 7500 products and we are importing around 6500 products. We have the great market. We have the great participants, participating in global trade. India is a global player right now. We all know what is our economy size. Right now we are $2.6 trillion economy. Just sixth position in the world. We have the sixth position in the world. So we are right now looking to go in the international market through the many ways. We want to increase our export more and more. We want to earn more and more foreign reserves. So we can save our economy, we can establish more and more our economy. See, there is a first way. It is a first way, exporting. Exporting, you know, where a country is selling out its product beyond its geographical boundaries. What is it? When a country is selling out its product beyond its boundaries, it is called the exporting. It has also two ways. One is direct exporting. Direct, what is it? Direct exporting.